Hello everyone, my name is Killchicken, and yes, I do still exist. I'm back to review some LEGO Minecraft sets. I didn't even do a lot of research on what the new sets even were, but I'm a simple man. When I go to the store and I see LEGO Minecraft sets, I buy LEGO Minecraft sets. This one specifically is the set 21164, the Coral Reef. And something that probably really sticks out to you from first glance is the pufferfish. I'm kidding. It's the drowned. This is a $10 set, and you get an exclusive so far, a brand new zombie minifigure, the drowned. So that is pretty sweet. You don't have to spend like $90 for a really big set that maybe you don't want. And just to get that exclusive minifigure. No, this is $10 and it has a drowned. Something that I did notice is it doesn't come with a trident, so that's making me think that maybe they'll make a new set with another drowned in it who has a trident, maybe in a more expensive set. So he's probably not going to stay exclusive to this, but that's just speculation. I don't have any evidence to back that up. Anyway, yeah, this does retail for $9.99, has, 92 pieces, so that's pretty good price-to-piece ratio. Again, yes, it does have a puffer fish as well as a baby puffer fish. And as you can see, either that is a dyed green leather helmet, or it's a turtle shell. I'm guessing it's the latter because I don't think you would take a leather helmet to the bottom of the sea. Quick look at the box art. As you can see, they're kind of drawing from the previous wave with the kind of weird angle thing they've got here with the kind of dirt blocks coming in at also a weird angle. You've got kind of the sky here. See, with the also the inclusion of the kind of main animal in this set down there in the corner. See, up at the top we got the actual size reference for the pufferfish. Again, more of that kind of dirt and grass block. Here at the back, of course, you've got the push tab and some of the features shown off in the set, as well as just a different angle or different look at the minifigures. Yeah, basically just your normal $10 box size. Here's the instruction manual, very small as expected. You've got the QR code to get the digital version in the LEGO Life app. And at the back, you've got the piece count as well as the other sets in this specific wave. You've got this kind of little mine looking thing, the abandoned mine, the trading post, bee farm, and the pig house. Now, I'm probably going to stay away from the pig house. You guys know I'm not much into the animal things. So if it's like a house literally built to look like an animal, I don't think I'm going to waste my time with that one. Here's the set all built up. Of course, let's take a quick look at the minifigures and characters before we look at the set itself. Starting off with the hero of this set is Alex. The sand green shirt is looking nice with just the normal printing that Alex always has. The enchanted pants, of course, we don't know if that is leather. We don't know if it is diamond or iron because they don't blend colors together, which is a little high-tech for LEGO, but would be great to see in the future. Let's see, her face print looks pretty good. Minecraft has the tendency to jack up the face print, which we'll see for the next minifigure. But she does have a nice kind of turtle shell for the helmet, I'm guessing is what that is. Of course, they don't actually have that little thing sticking down in the middle, so if we're getting real picky, that is something that could have been improved, but I don't think they wanted to make a brand new mold for that. Of course, no side or back printing on the head. Would be cool to see in the future once, I guess, they have the budget for that. But the she has a golden sword, which is not the most durable weapon ever, but does deliver a substantial amount of damage. Next up, we have one of the best minifigures of the set. Well, one of the best of the two minifigures, that's funny. It's the drowned, and like I said, the face printing on LEGO Minecraft is not always pristine. As you can see, the white of his eyes are kind of escaping the black kind of border or outline. Also, his mouth is a little bit doing the same thing, too. It's a little tough to accept that when that happens, but I mean, it's looking at this thing far away, probably wouldn't notice it very much, but it would be great if they could make their prints more perfect, because is that really asking much? Can't we just have perfect prints? His accessory looks like a little shrimp, but I don't think that's what that is, but I could be wrong. I'm not exactly sure, because I haven't played Minecraft in ages. Anyway, the sand green on the brown is definitely giving me the old castle vibes with that weird orc character. Yeah, I remember he always had kind of brown pants, a brown shirt, and then the sand green was his skin tone. Also reminds me of the Gamorrean guard from the old Jabba's Palace sets. Yeah, all that kind of tattered up looking shirt printing on the back there looks amazing. I love the aqua color, the kind of darker green, and then of course the sand green printing is just really good. Makes this look definitely a lot like a slimy drowned zombie. So as far as the fish go, this is the normal sized puffer fish before he's all blown up. The printing on his face looks pretty good. Pixels are in pretty good alignment there. I love the sand blue color they used for his fins. I like the kind of orangish yellow, kind of the bright, almost fiery yellow color. It just always looks really good. Also a little point in the back for his back fin. So yeah, pretty good, accurate Minecraft fish build. Now the puffed up puffer fish looks even better. Now as far as that printing on the face goes, that's what I call pretty much perfect. It has better printing than the drowned. That's not really fair. Of course, the fins are the same color, which I really like. There's that little tail on the back that I mentioned earlier on the smaller fish. The orange does look good, and really this overall looks like a perfectly puffed up version of the previous regular sized puffer fish. Again, just really nice. Oh, also, they both come with one of these one-by-one clear cylinders so that they can be kind of floating around underwater. So as far as the build goes, it is a very, very simple build. I would not be surprised if you could take the parts in your collection and duplicate this perfectly. Of course, it's probably just these kind of different variations of blue and pink that would probably be harder to come by, but as far as everything else goes, it's pretty much just standard Lego parts. It does look good, though. Now, I can't exactly tell you what these blocks are specifically, but I can say that if someone looks at this, they're going to say, that looks like something that'd be found underwater, so that's good. This, of course, is kelp, I'm sure. Either that, or it looks a lot like overgrown sugarcane or something. Now, I'm going to take a wild guess and say that that is a sea cucumber. I don't remember those ever being in Minecraft, but again, I have not played it in ages, so if so, that is a good replication of a sea cucumber. Now, it does have a play feature here on the back. I'm not exactly sure what this feature is supposed to represent, but you twist this little knob over here, and a chest kind of pops out of this little crevice, and that's, I guess, interesting, but not sure what it's supposed to represent again. On the inside, you've got a little, probably a goldfish or a clownfish, not exactly sure, it could be a salmon. Then they have this kind of aqua-colored stud. First, when I saw it, I was like, hey, that must be a diamond, but I guess it's not a diamond because diamonds are a lighter blue color. If you know what that is, please tell me in the comments below because I do not. But yeah, that can slide right back in. They use this little rubber piece so that it can kind of bend around and move the chest in there as well as take it out, which is a good parts usage. But I mean, yeah, that is basically it. Some things that I probably would have improved is given the drowned a trident, because I just love the tridents. They're so cool. Would have made a really nice new mold too. Also, Alex's helmet for the turtle, I probably would have eliminated that little thing that kind of pokes down between the eyeballs. I don't know. It's a small gripe, but it would confuse someone who would maybe think that it is a green-colored, just regular helmet. Yeah, just a couple of little things, but overall, it's a really good set. You can get a bunch of these. You can build an army of drowned, and you can build, like, a really big kind of coral reef, and, you know, that's a really good idea. Also, if you just want the parts, it's a good set to buy for just the parts, too. Yeah, nothing too fantastic, but I mean, it's a $10 set, so what they do have in here is pretty good, though. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, or if I help you decide whether or not you're going to be picking this up, please subscribe, comment below your thoughts, of course. If you are subscribed, hit the bell icon to receive a solid notification for every time I post a video. Stay tuned for more Minecraft reviews. I'll see you guys next time.